All right, welcome to Pop Podium. Today's episode, Dread 2012.
Judgment time.
Yeah, the not Sylvester Stallone.
The not Stallone version, the newer version. Maybe we'll get to that one day. But, Dread 2012.
So, let's start with the top podium. What do you, I'm going to give it to you since, like, basically, how many times do you watch the movie a year?
I watch it every quarter, so every 3 months I watch it.
Every 3 months?
Yeah. It's tradition. It's my own tradition by myself that I do.
Yeah.
No, and sometimes tradition. I include people.
You know what? If anybody else has a tradition, please let us know in the comments.
Yeah. I think it's a super underrated movie. Just want to say. Didn't get a lot of attention. So, I don't know what my top one is, but I think one of my points, maybe the second one, second or third for me, is going to be that the whole story wasn't... didn't have super high stakes. That might be my second. That when you watch the movie and you watch the whole story go on, it was just a... That's what he says at the end of the movie. Just another drug bust. Right?
Yeah,
that's
good it. Point, yeah.
Like, it wasn't like some crazy, oh, aliens are invading, the world's gonna end. It's like, I don't know, just he's a judge on patrol.
Yeah.
You know, busting in drugs.
It's like, hey, this guy's gonna snap his finger and the world's gonna, like, you know, change.
Exactly. It's very, like... Low stakes global wise, but like character wise, the stakes were high. You know,
right?
So, but I think it was very refreshing in an action movie to not have like the end of the world imminent. So that was.
Is that your first podium?
I think it's my second.
Second.
I think it's my second one.
Okay, so I was thinking about the first one because I don't love the movie as much as you do. Yeah. I like it. Great movie. I'm not trying. You know.
Yeah.
No. I don't watch it 3 times a year.
That's fair.
Four times a year. 4 times a year.
Every 3 months.
Must have like an addiction.
It is definitely my top 5 favorite movies of all time. For some reason,
I have to watch that often. There's no movie.
For some reason, I love this movie. But right. Yeah, so
I would say the moment where it was like, okay, I was watching the beginning of the movie when he's like, you know, on his bike going through and he's like gets
classic
the first guys right.
I'm
like, okay, this movie is like still a good movie. I'm like, okay, I like this movie, right? But it was when the girl came in.
Okay.
That I was like, okay, this stopped being like a campy, stupid 80s movie. Mm-hmm. Or an 80s mock-up, because it's 2012, really.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, now this movie has like a real punch to it to give us along with the Dread character, who is an 80s classic dude with like the canny lines or whatever.
Like grizzled one-liner kind of guy.
Yeah.
That's fair.
He's great in his own. Like, I'm like, when I was watching the first few scenes, I'm like, oh, it's gonna be a funny movie, like a fun action-packed movie.
But like campy.
Yeah, but then the girl comes in, like, okay, now they actually get weight to this movie too.
She definitely adds depth to it.
Yeah.
Where like watching Dredd kind of do his thing alone.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, eh.
Exactly.
You know, that's fair.
Exactly.
That's fair.
But if it was also just her, it wouldn't
be
good
at all. Yeah.
It has to be both of them. So I think what it was is, for me at least, what got me into the movie a lot was like their mentorship thing. That like rookie being thrown to the wolves kind of thing. Then you have the old veteran who's like, oh,
yeah.
This is just another drug bust. Like, yeah, that's like so, that was like so classic that it worked so well for this movie. Because she's literally running around without a helmet. And I think the writers made her run around without a helmet so you could see her reactions and like, what's the word? Relate to her.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Also in the comics, which is based on, Dredd never is drawn without his helmet. So like this, that was like, that's why they did that. Because like in the Stallone one, he had his helmet off the whole damn movie.
Oh yeah.
And in this one, like the guy, you know, Carl Urban, he kept his helmet on the whole time, just like in the comics, which like was a big deal. Because like, you know, he's like to get paid and be in a movie and not have your face shown is kind of crazy.
Yeah.
But you know, he stuck to that, which is really cool on his part. But I definitely think, Anderson is her name. I think that she definitely adds depth to the movie. I could definitely see, I like that.
Would you give her the top
point? I could give her the top point. Because
like, not important. Just her. It's
their dynamic.
It's their dynamic. Fact that she's the rookie.
Yeah.
And then he's the extreme veteran.
Yeah. And it's like, you know, not only is she a rookie, but she's also like a psychic. So you get to see that kind of play out too.
Well, she's a very emotional person. Like she understands and relates to people around her. Until she snaps
at the end.
And all that was important, because like, we're watching it. If you were just watching it with just Dredd, it'd be like watching Master Chief just plow through the Covenant.
Yeah.
Right? But it's like also watching him plow through the Covenant, and then you're watching this one girl trying to think, hey, what the hell is wrong with him? And then all of a sudden snapping and realize, oh. And then she starts saying the one-liners and stuff towards the end of the movie.
Yeah. That's fair. I think his like tough guy thing might have gotten old after a while. Not for me, but for most of you, a lot of people might have gotten old after a while.
You can
if
watch
not
a
12-hour
movie.
I could watch a 12-hour movie just him talking
to
himself.
Yeah,
but like, I don't know. I feel like that she definitely helped like us, like the viewer, put themselves in the movie. Because right. like when you're watching the movie, you can't put yourself in Dredd's shoes because he's Dredd. But you can put yourself in Anderson's shoes. You know, she wants to make a difference. She's like trying to help people. You know, whereas Dredd is like literally just like literally the law. Mm-hmm. Like he is the law. That's it. Like he does not have any emotion or opinion. He just enforces the law. You know, which I. Like that's why I love that scene with the like the homeless guy underneath that blast door.
Oh my god, yeah, yeah.
And like they're going to investigate the murders, and he's like, "I'm gonna arrest you when we come back for you know sitting there."
This is a war.
Yeah. So that was you know definitely interesting. So I could give their dynamic the top spot.
Okay.
I could agree to that. All but right. I think then the second one would be what I said earlier.
The lack of stakes.
The lack of crazy stakes. So it kind of makes it more enjoyable, just kind of like relaxing movie.
I will agree with you on that. I was going to say my second one was going to be, I was kind of thinking the intensity of it. Remember,
ooh, okay.
Remember when we were watching it and they throw the drug dealer, Mama,
yeah.
off the thing?
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm like, oh, how are they going to show her dying? I'm like trying to
think. Oh, yeah.
And then they show like her face coming in, like it's on the glass.
You, yeah.
And I almost threw up and I was like, God, what the fuck is wrong with this movie?
Yeah.
I was like, oh my god.
You know but what?
But also,
that's fair.
That, because they have those scenes with the entire movie. Yeah. Like when they threw the three bodies off and you hear them slap onto the ground.
That movie starts off with that. The three bodies just slapping like uncooked meat on the ground.
Oh my god. I was like, oh god, what are you making me watch?
All the shootouts were like really bloody.
Yeah.
Definitely didn't shy away from like gore.
It did not.
Yeah.
And honestly, while I didn't like it, because I was like, oh my god, what the hell? My other part of my brain was like, okay, focus now.
Yeah.
You know? And it worked.
It definitely made you take it more seriously. I feel like it did a good job showing how severe everything was.
Yeah. So, what do you think deserves second podium? That or... Because we can put it at the third podium.
We could. I think the intensity, I'll give it to. Because I think the intensity is what drives the movie. Like,
that's why you keep going to it.
That's why I keep going. Yeah. So, I think that's a great point. I think the intensity definitely gets second spot. Or just like intensity, gore.
Okay, so the third spot is the one I couldn't really figure out.
Okay. All right, so then we go.
Yeah.
So the thing with the low stakes is like the more we're talking about it now, it's like with the lower stakes of like, you know, world ending, you know, domination or whatever, when you don't have that, you kind of have to focus on the characters more. You know? So with Dredd, like, he's not fighting to save the world, and you're, like, thinking, oh, my God, the world could end if he messes up. It's, if he messes up, he just dies. Yeah. That's it.
Yeah.
That's all that happens. Like, him and Anderson die, and then life goes on. So it's really not that big of a deal in the grand scheme of things, but that makes you focus on him and Anderson more, which kind of plays into the first podium.
The writers have to focus on the
characters. Of course, yeah. And it kind of plays into the first podium of, like, their dynamic being the driving point, where it's, like, really, you're just rooting for them to win and survive against Mama and her gang. And it's kind of like that. The lack of stakes brings that element to the movie, where like you're so dialed into the characters, and like you're rooting for them personally. Like you're not rooting for them to save the world. You're not even really rooting for them to like beat Mama. You're just rooting for them to get out of there alive. Because by the end of it, I don't really care. Like obviously you wanted to see her get justice, right? But like, I didn't really care too much if they beat her and won. I just kind of wanted to see them get out of there safely.
Yeah, I won. Especially Anderson.
Yeah, well, especially Dredd was gonna
get out.
Yeah,
because like Dredd, he got that one bullet through the back, the armor piercing one, and he got up and stood up to that. I'm like, okay, Dredd clearly is on some shit.
Yeah,
field dressing. So he's Dredd.
Yeah,
but Anderson was clearly like this like rookie who was trying to figure everything out, and like very compassionate person. I was like, oh god, she's gonna die.
Yeah,
she's so, and especially because they had her in the traps of Mala.
Yeah.
You know, like if Dredd was in the traps of Mama, I thought maybe Dredd would die.
Yeah, no, that part definitely could have seen her dying. When I first watched it, obviously, yeah. I've seen it so many times now. But like that scene when Kay captures her and takes her back to Mama, it's like definitely like you don't know what's going to happen. But then obviously, you know, she gets out because the gun ID fails and Kay's arm blows up. But I just feel like that, yeah, definitely like you're rooting for them just to survive.
Yeah.
Which kind of makes it more like a primal feeling when you're watching that movie, just like, you know, adrenaline pumping the whole time.
Honestly, that, you know, there's some movies I feel like that have this innate rewatchability to them.
Mm.
And I think the Dredd has an innate rewatchability to it.
Yeah.
For sure.
I think it's because of the lack of insane plot. Yeah. Like there's not any huge twist, you know, or any big twist. There's not like some crazy complicated plot to follow. It's very much like we were saying, like watching a video game almost.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, which is why it's so rewatchable. 100%. It's just action. The whole straight action.
With peach trees, right? Yeah, that's the name of the main tower.
Yeah.
That setup is like asking for a video game.
It really is.
It lit, like, so much.
Yeah, and the action scenes were so good, like we saw with the intensity. Yeah. So it made it, like, you know, deserving. It was such a good formula that somehow came together and just made a very classic rewatchable movie. I agree with that.
I will say the only thing you have to, if you're like in that modern movie mindset, is like you have to get back to the 80s movie mindset a little bit with Dredd's lines. Once you're like, okay, these lines aren't stupid, no one would say them, like, oh, I'm watching a movie. Dredd's lines become amazing.
Yeah, that's, yeah, you know, I, because I don't mind that stuff, but I could definitely see some people be like, oh, this is kind of too cheesy. But it's like, you're right, you have to let your brain sift back into, like, the 1980s Stallone Schwarzenegger era of, like, cheesy lines being tough still. And once you let yourself kind of fall into that, it becomes a lot more, you know,
very enticing. Enjoyable. Very enjoyable.
Yeah.
You know, it's probably because we watch this movie so often. I was like, yeah, whatever. He can just say that. He said those lines, you know.
It's like, he is Dredd.
But anybody else would be like, what?
Yeah. That's fair. I could see, like, some new viewers thinking that way about this movie.
So that's our podium for Dredd. It's the mentor, rookie versus veteran thing.
Just their whole, I think their whole dynamic, because there's so many levels and layers to what they bring to the table and with each other, that I think their whole dynamic is just podium one. Spot two is the insane intensity, right? And then spot three would be the lack of world-ending stakes, which drives
character more. And which a lot of action movies don't have anymore.
They most action movies I can think of off the top of my head have like world-ending stakes.
Avengers.
Yeah.
You know, would name another action movie. Terminator.
Like, they all have world-ending stakes. So it's kind of refreshing to just see that. So I think it's a good three.
Yeah.
I think it's a solid three.
So what do you want next?
Next, keep an eye out for...
Do you want to do Interstellar?
Ooh, yeah. I haven't seen that yet.
That's the movie I watch every now and then. Not four times a year.
But still.
Okay. Maybe like once every 2 years.
So keep an eye out for Interstellar. That's coming next.
Yeah, you like that movie.
Yeah.
All right, cool. All right, see you guys.